Hello, Madan.
Yeah.
Hey, you're not feeling well?
No, I'm good. Good morning.
Good morning. Good evening. Yeah, thanks. So, did you get some chance to go through the something yesterday?
I just went to the some pages, but not completely.
Oh, okay, no issue. Take your time. Okay. And out of 13 sessions, within 10 sessions, I'll be able to cover everything. And 3 sessions I have kept reserved for you for any kind of doubt clearance, certification related things, project related things, anything. Okay. So I'll just start sharing my screen.
That 1702 document you sent, right? The certification related questions.
That is not much changed actually. So I have also checked with my friends. So there is not that much change. So the LMS almost questions comes similar questions. Still, I will check with some many of my friends. So they also told the same thing. So similar questions only come. Same almost. Okay. So anyway, you don't have to worry about that.
Okay. I just came from office.
Okay. So it's the timings are normal. I mean, 10 o'clock to 7 or how is it there?
It is 8 to 5 usually.
Okay.
But due to the project I told you, right, that okay. Makes some time.
So you work in client side or you work in the office only?
I work from client side.
Client side, okay. So it's proper Chicago, right?
Proper Chicago.
Okay. So you stay nearby or some?
Out of Chicago. Chicago is little costly to stay.
Okay. So up and down every day?
Up and down every day.
Okay, nice.
So you're staying in Pune, is it?
No. I'm staying in Gurgaon.
Oh, Gurgaon, you said.
Gurgaon, yeah. Actually, I stay near to office only.
Okay.
So for me, travel is very hectic. So for the last almost five years here in Deloitte. Okay. In September, I'll be completing 5 years. So it's a walkable distance, and just that is the only positive here.
Okay. Yeah. I was worked there in Gurgaon for 3 months for Kane Energy Pro. It's that is a client, Kane Energy.
Kane. Understood. C-A-I-R-N, right? Okay. Good.
C-A-I-R-N, yeah.
Understood. So I heard about it, yeah.
Yeah, I was there for some time. Okay.
So today, actually, I will be focusing the more towards the security part. Okay. So yesterday, we have seen...
Is it possible to record this session?
You can record, I think.
I don't know how to do that.
There should be some, if you go, there is an option, chat invite in the last 3 dots are there. Okay, you can start recording, I think. I think it is automatically recorded somewhere. So it is showing pause recording, stop recording. So it must be recorded somewhere. I will check. Okay, this one. I think automatically it is recording somewhere.
Please request recording permission from the meeting host. Yeah, it is. I think you are recording, I think.
I think so. Are you able to record yourself or there also?
No, it is asking like if I press record button, please request recording permission from the meeting host.
You just send me a request if it is asking.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
Yeah.
We're done.
I should get some pop-up or something. Speaker, participants, Madam, more. Allow record. Okay, I did.
You did?
Okay. I allowed you record. There is actually, I clicked Madam and there is a more option there. And I allowed you to record it. You just start recording and just let me know.
Okay.
You are able to record. Yeah.
It's recording, but I don't know where it is recording.
It will be stored somewhere in your system, so no need to worry about that. We can figure it out also. Okay. So we will start today with in a new topic, that is your security part. Okay. Yesterday we have seen a little bit of items, curricula, what is the program.
Catalog.
So the catalog, schedule offering. So just an overview of how, given everything. So today we will be covering the most important topic. So whenever you start an implementation, the provisioning part I'll become later on because there is nothing to do in much in provisioning. It's just an URL setup. So whatever SAP will be giving, those URL you have to just fix it there and you activate whatever the features you require. That's the only thing that is very easier. Okay. So for that reason, I kept it that in the last. And for actually on the priority basis, I'm explaining to you today. I'll be covering the security topic. Okay.
So just an overview you are giving or the configuration one?
Configuration, I'm going deep. And configuration and security, I'm going and just I will just start with an overview, then I'll go deep into domain. Okay. Because this is the critical point of LMS. So without this, your basic, the core baseline configuration, this is the baseline configurations. Okay. So I'll just explain what it is and how it works. Okay. So before we start, I will just give you an analogy, because I always give an analogy to compare the technical things. Imagine you are having a house, okay? Your own house, you are having your different, you will be having different rooms, okay? Like suppose you are having a study room, you are having your bedroom, you are having your kitchen room, okay? And in that room, you will be having a different access. Suppose it's a very huge apartment, and you have specific access to specific room. Okay. Suppose there is a kid, and there are some guests, and there are some people which are coming from outside. In that case, what will happen? All the guests will not be having access to all the rooms. Suppose say, okay, so they will be having access to your common room, or say it's a drawing room. So just an hypothetical example I am giving. And your kid will be having access to his or her study room, some kind of access. So similarly, and each room is also having a key to it. Okay, suppose one kid is studying in his study room and he is having its key. And as a owner of your apartment, you will be having the key of all the rooms. Okay, so you are the authority. Similarly, in SuccessFactor LMS, we have a concept of domain and domain restriction. Okay, so imagine domain is a kind of a room and domain restriction is a kind of a key. Okay, so for each room, you will be having your keys. Similarly, in each domain in SuccessFactor has its own key. Okay, means domain restriction. Okay, suppose I'm explaining to a domain. Domain means the area or the privileges which are the having a particular LMS admin will have. So to give an example, suppose this is a multi-country implementation. So there are, say, around 90 plus countries which this LMS has been implemented, and all LMS admin has their own access, means all each country. Okay. So here you can see there are some countries like Argentina, Australia, Asia Pacific, Brazil, China. We have a lot of domain ID. Okay. And all each domain will be having its own learning admin. Okay.
So this is a standard domain, is it?
There is no standard domain. You have to create from scratch.
SAP
SuccessFactor gives the platform. Okay. So these are all the 99 domains. If you see, actually there is a standard domain also that is called public domain. Okay. So there is a standard thing. I will show you that. So similarly, as a kid will be having access to its own study room, this own personal study room. Similarly, each admin will be having, the individual admin will be having their own access to their specific countries. Okay. So other than that, there will be a one super admin, or we may call in some organization like chief learning officer. Okay. The learning head or learning champion. So they use different organization. They use different terminologies to explain that. So the chief learning officer or the super admin, you can imagine as a house owner like you. So you are the authority of your entire house. So you will be having the master key of all the rooms and all the things. Okay. Similarly, the learning super admin or the chief learning officer, he or she will be having access to all domains. Okay. He can navigate through, say, all these country-specific domain, India, Dublin, France, or anywhere. If he wants, he can open and he can see what other things are there. But so here there is one standard thing. So you can see there is something called public. Okay. So this is the only domain which is offered by SuccessFactor LMS. That is the public domain. Suppose you are not putting any courses into a specific domain. that ultimately goes to the public domain. Okay. So when I say public domain, it means whatever the courses we are putting in public domain, anyone in anywhere can access that courses, whether it can be an item, whether it can be a curricula, whether it can be a catalog. So whatever things you are putting in the public domain, it will be available for everyone to go through. Okay. But if you are mixing, if you are putting into any specific domain, say SG or Singapore, only the people or the learners of Singapore or the employees of Singapore can access that particular catalog, particular item. So that is the overall concept of the domain. Okay. So how to create a domain? It is a very simple, just like any other entities. You just click create, add new. Then there will be, they will be asking, suppose if you are creating a for the first time, okay, and suppose you are creating for say India, okay, and India you are having say five different centers for five different branches of your office, and there will be a parent domain, say first we call it the root domain. Okay, suppose you are creating for India entity, India underscore test. I'm just giving a hypothetical example. So once you click this add, you are ready to create a domain. So this is my top level domain. Okay. So once you click say India test, also you can have your own branding, like you can have your own designing style, branding style, that I will be coming later. Branding is basically how the look and feel of the portal will be looking like, all those you can attach to it. So at present we have not created any branding here, so it is optional, it's not mandatory. Okay, so as soon as you create a domain, it will say the first domain, as it is a root domain or the parent domain, it will say the level is zero. Okay, so here you can see there is a level zero here. So you can also, there is something called select parent domain. Okay, so it is my parent domain India test itself, so we are not going to say that no, it is a parent domain, I don't want is any other parent domain. Okay, and next one is whenever you are creating a domain under India underscore test, then those are called child domain. Child domain or the leaf domain you can call it. So in that case you will be choosing that India underscore test is equal to, is your parent domain. So that is the parent and child domain concept. And next one is the domain types. So domain can be of multiple, so what is the purpose of that domain, whether you want to create any specific item specific, or it is a item domain type specific, or it is a delivery type, whatever, or is it only for assessment. So what purpose you are going to use, that you can add it here. So whatever, the you can also create a means add one or more from this list, or you can create a new also. You can attach to it. This is just a concept of domain and domain types. Okay, so next I will be coming to the I'll be creating a child domain under this. Okay, under India's underscore test, say I'll be creating a child domain, then I have to choose this second one, that is called subdomain. Also child domain is also called a subdomain. Suppose I am creating a subdomain for Chennai.
How in, I mean, what is the use of add subdomain?
Subdomain means suppose we are putting sub Chennai subdomain under India domain. So that is basically suppose the, some of the characteristics of the parent, it will inherit this child domain. Suppose parent domain is having access to all the exam items or the assessment. Suppose there is this options here, inherit parent level domain types, then it will carry for, means all the inherit all these properties of the parent domain. That is one concept. Second one is basically you can segregate. Suppose there is a main catalog, under that you have a many things which you want to segregate some specific courses to specific. So say for Chennai, you will be having a specific catalog for Chennai. Suppose it is a manufacturing plant, Chennai plant, you want some specific courses. And for say Jammu and Kashmir, you want another catalog. So similarly, you can create subdomain ID just to segregate. Means only the Chennai users, because some, there are some in some courses which is applicable only for the Chennai plant, okay, because the plant has a different requirement. But suppose you have another plant in Jammu Kashmir which is having a different setup, okay, and we have different set of machines and things, and those trainings are different, okay. So you can segregate those training by using this concept of domain, okay. So it is similar to domain only. So it is another domain which is coming under another one parent domain. But the concept remains the same. The characteristic remains the same if you are going to inherit the domain type. So we will be going deeper. Like I'll be also giving you a case study, like how you can, I'll be giving a real-time case study actually in the next 3 to 4 days. So you'll be having an overall idea like how this domain and domain restriction works. Okay, so you'll be able to understand. Just now, you just theoretically you understand that these are the things we have concept. All these concepts you just remember. So here it is asking select parent domain. So I don't have to select create Chennai here. I'll be choosing the parent domain. That is my, say it is India, who is the parent domain I have created. India_test. Under India_test, let's see, I'll be writing a subdomain, Chennai_manufacturing. And you can write a short description. Then it is always we prefer to click this inherit parent label domain type so that it will inherit whatever the properties you have in the India_test. It will go to the Chennai_manufacturing. Okay. Then but after that you can segregate go to the individual domain. You can create your these things. Okay. Like so, if you see in the domain ID, it is showing now as level 1. Okay. So India_test was the level 0. And in level 1 is the next to Chennai manufacturing. Okay. So this is just one example I have given. Okay. So similarly, you can have level 2, level 3, but it is not recommended to go very deep. Like it should not be more than 2 to 3 level. It is not a best practice because it sometimes creates operational issues. So it is always suggested to go maximum 2 to 3 level, not beyond that. So this is just a concept of domain and this thing, domain type, and I've covered and how to create a domain and how to attach it to a subdomain. Then next, I'll be coming to the domain restrictions. Okay. So domain restriction also, these are the different keys, as I have told you, means these are the key to open any specific domain. Okay. So you can think of it's similar to your RBP. Role-based permissioning in you have done right, understood right?
Role-based RBP.
It is similar to RBP, but it is, you can call it as LMS RBP, LMS own RBP, role-based permissioning for this thing. We will be coming to the role management just within the next 10 minutes. So I'll just before that I'll be giving this hint of domain restriction. Okay. So what happens? You have created India_test, Chennai_manufacturing, all those domains. But now you want to restrict something which is applicable only for Chennai. So then only creating the domain is not sufficient. Okay. You have to attach a key also. Means that is called your domain restriction. So how to restrict any specific courses to only Chennai or only Jammu Kashmir or any specific to Maharashtra or any specific domain you are creating. So that is the concept of domain restriction. And suppose in here, you can see there are some few examples like US, they have given US_Exton, US_Exon, DOC, US Exon. So these are the small examples. So similarly, one domain can have multiple domain restriction also. Okay. Suppose inside Chennai, you will be having, just I'll be showing you how to create a new domain restriction. So by default, it will say it's a public domain. Okay. So, but we will not be going with the public domain. Rather, we will be creating some domain restriction for Chennai. Say, so I have created the base structure for domain. That is called domain ID, Chennai_manufacturing. Then I have to be creating a domain restriction ID for Chennai, but it can happen for Chennai. Under Chennai manufacturing, you will be having different departments. Suppose it's a mechanical, civil, IT, HR. So you want to again further domain restriction. So you can create specific domain restriction ID for specific department as well.
Okay, but the subdomain only you have created is Chennai manufacturing, right?
Subdomain only. Yeah.
But it is showing here as domain.
Yeah, it will be called as a domain. So don't be confused on that. It is called domain, but for while creating the domain restriction, it will not consider as a subdomain. Subdomain when I refer to or compare to India_test, but independent. Okay. Suppose if you are calling it independent entities, Chennai, Maharashtra, Jammu, Kashmir, Gujarat. Suppose those are independent all subdomain can also be a domain. Okay, so don't be confused about that. So if you are talking about the entire structure, domain structure, then we have a concept of parent domain, child domain, or the main domain, subdomain. But if you are talking about the individual independent domain, that is treated as a domain itself. It is an independent, self-containing kind of domain. So we can create a domain restriction ch_d1, which is for HR department, or any specific department wise, you can create multiple domain restriction ID. So while creating domain restriction, we have two options here. So one is the summary page, next one is the domains. So domain here, you can see by default public domain will be given to every domain restriction. Okay, so you can't remove it. So as you can see, there is no remove options. Public domain will be available for each domain restriction because public domain has not any restriction. So here I can add a new domain also. So what I am going to do here, this is just for your overview, means how you can see, suppose there is an existing Argentina domain ID specific to Argentina. So it is having three levels. Okay, for Buenos Aires, so under Buenos Aires, they will be having some further domain. So here you can see specific domain. So it is not necessary only you will be having access to the Chennai specific. Also, it gives a flexibility. Suppose in India, they have given one for Hyderabad, one for some another city. Similarly, we can have Chennai as well. As suppose there is an HR sitting in Chennai, but he is also responsible for another location, say Bangalore. Okay, but in Bangalore you don't have any HR. So by sitting in Chennai, he can have access to both Bangalore as well as your Chennai, both the locations. So for that reason, we can have here, we are given option to choose one or two multiple things, multiple domain you can choose here. That is the concept. So as I have chosen India_test, this is my parent domain. So here I can choose this India_test. So here I am giving Chennai manufacturing related courses these options, as well as suppose here I have not created any Bangalore related things, but suppose you are taking care of Hyderabad as well. Okay. So then you will be having access to both Hyderabad as well as Chennai related all the training program. Because you are a single person to handle both the locations, then you can add. So these are the domain restriction you can add to a specific domain. So I have added Chennai_manufacturing or Hyderabad_IN_innovation_Hyderabad. So these two things I have given to this particular domain restriction. Okay. So now I'll be coming to the concept of the role. What is a role and how it is created and everything. So you have clarity about domain and domain restriction, right? Any questions you have?
No, domain restriction is, it is for the location base.
Not necessarily. So exactly, it is not necessarily location based. It can be also, I'll be giving a case study. So it can be also, say, HR department of five locations, they are coming together. You can have one domain restriction ID. Also, it can be possible, suppose in only one location, say Chennai or Hyderabad, you have different departments. Suppose it's the HR department, finance department, your another IT department, but the chief technology officer is taking care of all these three. So in that case, the chief technology officer will be having access to all these three domains. So mostly it's a common practice that we make it a location wise, but it is not mandatorily that you have to do only the location specific, because we have all other options also. But mostly we recommend to go for location. It is easy to visualize and it is easy to do this thing. But it is possible, whatever the business scenarios. We have a lot of flexibilities in case of creating this domain and domain restriction. Any other questions you have?
No, I'm good.
So you'll be understand. Means once I will be giving a problem statement to you, so you will be able to visualize what is the domain restriction. Because it's the initial discussion when you discuss with the clients in during the initial workshop, so they have to come up with this what will be fitting to their organizational structure. Okay, it can be a mirror of their organizational structure also. How they are, you have to understand their org structure, like that is in Employee Central. You can mirror that also. You can have your own little bit tweaking also. We can do in LMS depending upon your, because if the business case is different for LMS, in that case, okay, you can do that. Next, the third one is the role management. So it is the hardcore RBP. So what happens? So in role, we have some standard roles here. Like you can see, whatever it is, the description is starting with a default. That is your standard role. Okay. So I'll just click search default. So these are my default role. Default either in description or it is starting with all. Okay. If it is all, means you are the super admin. Okay, so if I'm giving all role ID, so you'll be having a role ID and role description in each role management, like all connectors. What is a connector? I'll be coming later on. Similarly, all performance, default instructor, default user. So these are these things. But in this, actually, the test system, they have not changed this text. So they have something waste_learning_user. Ideally, this should change. Whenever you're customizing anything, you start copying it. And you have to actually change this text to of your own. But here in the test environment, they have not done. Okay, but these are the standard things: all connector, all performance, default instructor, default user, learning_admin, default learning admin role. So these are my different roles. Okay, so if I go to individual role, say learning, I'm going to learning_admin role. Here you can see there are six different things. First one is a summary. Okay, so in the summary section there are three things. In the top you can see there are two things. One is the role ID, second one is the description. So role ID, basically there should not be any space. Okay, whenever you are creating any role ID, this is the standard role ID. So generally what we do, we copy this role. So there is an option here, apply changes, copy role, reset. We generally copy this role to our new role. And whatever the restriction are not required, we remove that workflow or the functions. We remove that from that new role which we create. Okay, but okay. It is suggested not to touch anything on the standard as per the all of the best practices. Learning_admin. So you should not touch anything, like change anything in this workflow function entity restriction. Okay, so ideally, whenever during your implementation, you copy this role to the new role. And you do the changes, whatever things are required there. So this is a summary page. So first I will be explaining what is an entity. Okay, so in SuccessFactors, what happens? So all these things, account code, your items, class, connector, your domain ID, exam, all these are called your entities. Okay. And whenever entity means, so like say I'm going for an item type, these are called your entity. And when I say to function means your activities. Okay. So I'm expanding all this. So these are my entities, you can see. So if I expand these entities, so you can see a lot of things under each entities, like adding, deleting, editing, all the verb, like adding, deleting, editing, searching, viewing, all these are called my functions. So all these are verbs are called functions. Okay. Whenever I'm telling about you item, whether you can delete an item, add an item, create an item, view an item, all these are called your functions. Okay. So here in this whatever I'm showing you, one is your entity restriction, another is your function restriction. Okay. Next is your workflow. Workflow restriction is basically in SuccessFactor, workflow is little bit don't confused about the ABAP workflow or the SAP workflow what we have understood previously. So this is basically in SuccessFactor, workflow is equal to entity plus function. You just remember, it is a mathematical, it's just a formula. Workflow is equal to entity plus function. Okay. So whenever I'm saying, I'll be giving one example here. Suppose I'm saying add item or add anything or copy program, copy location. So it is a comprises of your one entity, one is your function. So copy material, what is the entity? Entity is your material, copy is the function. So copy material is your workflow. Okay. Similarly, add item. So in or edit, say I'm saying edit item. So in this case, item is your entity, edit is your function, and edit item, this is your entire workflow. Okay. So by coming to this role, we generally give access to here. So here we do all kind of permutation combination, what role, which you admin will be getting what access. So that kind of permissioning, we give it here. Like suppose an admin will be having only edit option or view option. So that domain restriction, we call it here. So previously we have seen the domain, whatever the domain restriction was there. So we generally give the domain restriction at the workflow level. We call that domain restriction here and we attach the domain restriction to the workflow here. Okay. So this is the overall concept of entire role management. So here also, if you want to remove any workflow, then you have to just come here. I'm not doing anything in the standard thing. So whenever you are copying anything, now after that, suppose you don't want to give the report permissioning to an admin. So you just go there in the ad hoc report or any specific report you don't want to give, you just click it and apply changes. Then that role, that workflow will be removed from that particular role. So this is the way we can control all kind of our role permissions. This is the permissioning also, it controlled by here. This is concept of entity, function and workflow. So we don't have any kind of manage role permission, manage role, though whatever things we have seen in the RPP, those things are not inside this LMS admin. Okay. We have a special this thing, entity plus function here, that is your workflow. So this is the process you need to follow and workflow for workflow and workflow restriction. This is about overall roles. Then users means people who are part of this particular role. I mean, suppose there is a role ID, say learning_admin. Who are the people who is having this role? That you can come and see here, user permission. So all this admin, here I can see there is only one admin, Lucas. He is having this learning_admin role. Okay. Similarly, whenever you will be going to a specific roles, you can visualize all these roles. What are the roles we have? So here you can see there is a they have created a reporting and view only. So West_reporting. So only here they have given access to all the report access, LMS related report access. So if you see, only the reports part they have given. I think in the test system they have not done it properly. So ideally all the reports would be there. So whatever the things, only the view access, there is no edit or add options was there. So similarly, you can create as many as admins, your admin roles, and you can define your security structure for LMS. So this is an overall concept of how to concept of entity functions and your workflow restrictions. So just remember one thing, your workflow is equal to entity plus function. Okay. So whenever you are creating any role, it is basically a workflow attached to a user in LMS admin. So that is the overall concept of the security part.
Can we create one role and
I will just explain. So I'll just go to that. What I will do, I'll be showing one role. So as a best practices, we basically always copy the standard admin. So this is a standard admin role, right? I'm not touching anything. I will just copy a role.
Okay.
Whenever you are assigning, creating, it will ask for the new role ID. Suppose I'm creating, say, for India, LMS admin. So it will ask whether you want to copy all these assigned workflow, entity, function, workflow from the parent, that is your learning admin, or you want to create your own. Okay. So always it is suggested copy everything. Then whatever you are means you don't require, you just remove that. So it is a easy way of doing. Okay. So once you copy everything, now I will just click copy. It will take some time. So once it is created, it will say that yes, the automatically role will be shown here. Okay, India underscore LMS underscore admin. Okay, suppose you don't want to, you want to change this, just you change the description here. So don't keep default here. It's a learning admin role for India. And then also you don't keep the domain as a public. Well, it is always best practices to choose the specific this thing, specific to a domain. So I've just called my domain, specific domain there. I'll choose this India underscore test. So now I'll click apply changes. So my role is now created. Now whatever the things I require, I don't require, I will just go to each individual workflow and I can just expand it and I can change it, whatever the depending upon your business requirement. Okay. This is the best way to copy the standard one and you give your access, whatever the permission access, okay. Depending upon the you, here you'll be getting all the options here. Domain restriction, if you want to give any specific domain restriction, then you can give it here. So I have created this Chennai underscore D1 domain restriction, right? So I'll be giving this domain restriction. Okay. So whatever the domain restriction, domain restriction is basically the key. Whatever the key I'll be giving to a particular thing, I can have only access to that particular domain. So every time you do any changes, you don't forget to click this apply changes.
So if this role has been assigned to any other people, which will also change, is it? I mean, say for example, since we are modifying the existing role.
Yes. So suppose this role has been assigned to a particular user, then he will be getting the additional access. So at present, you can see there is nobody using this role. Okay. So he or she is not assigned to this role. So I'll be showing how to assign the role also next session. So this is. Whatever the changes you will be doing, it will immediately affect all the users who will be taking care of, who is attached to that particular role ID. That is a standard thing. Okay. So any other questions you have, you'll be getting a case study. Once I give a case study, you will be doing a hands-on and you'll be showing to me whether you have achieved that or not. Okay. So then you will be getting the overall idea, the domain concept or domain restriction, the role management. But it is simple. It's not very complex. Just the terminology, you have to understand the difference. So many people don't understand the difference between the domain and domain restriction. And also they are not able to explain to the client properly. The client also, they get confused. And at the time, the implementation gets stuck in a different reason because of the understanding gap. So you have to very much clear about the domain and domain restriction. You always use whatever the analogy I have given. Similar analogy you can give to the client. So this is basically the room and key concept. So my client was earlier client was very they forgot the definition, exact definitions of domain and domain restriction, but they remembered this room and key concept. Okay. So you have a room and you have a key. So key, unless you open the key, you can't enter into the room. Okay. So similarly, unless you are having domain restriction, you can't go and enter into a particular domain. It is as simple as that. So next I'll be showing you something related to the application admin. So till now we have seen the security part. Okay. So here I can go and create a LMS admin. This is the point whenever you are going for an implementation. Here we come and create the admin here. Okay. So how to create a new admin? You have to just simple click add new. Then you have to give the admin ID, whatever the admin ID you want to give, say so then I'll be giving the specific domain. India_test. Then related user is basically the user who is existing already in the system. Okay. Means suppose there is an employee because LMS admin also an employee. And he is also a learner. Okay, so here you basically we are attaching that related user. Okay, so say I'm attaching an existing user ID. So ideally, it is a test system. I'm not creating this. So ideally, it should be same. So whatever the admin ID you'll be using, you'll be using the same related user avoid the all kind of confusion. Okay, so but it is not necessarily it can be also different. So SAP LMS doesn't restrict that, it can be different, but it is better to have the same ID. So as it is already test system, so I am able to create all these things. So here I can give an email ID. And don't worry about this new password and verify password. Again, it is a plateau feature. You can give anything here. So this password is not nowhere going to be helpful because we are using the BizX platform password. So this is just for an overview. So here they have restriction something. So let me. This is a one-time activity for while creating the admin.
Okay.
I think they had some password restriction. They have kept it here, but actually it is not required. Okay. Now I have created a admin. Okay. So India_admin and the name is Bharat Bhushan S. So he is the admin. Okay. And here, you can see there are two things. One is assigned role, one is preferences. So assigned roles, if I go, this is the place where you can attach a role. So we have seen the security structure, domain restriction role. Now I'm going to add a role to this particular admin. Okay. So that specific role which we have created, that we will search, say it was something India. So this is the admin role which we have created, right? India underscore LMS underscore admin. So I'm just going to click this, add this role to this user or the admin. Okay. Now you can see this role is attached to this. So this is the process you have to follow whenever you are going to adding a particular role. Also similar process you have to follow. Suppose if you want to remove, you have to just click remove and apply changes. So this role will be removed from this admin. Okay. This is a process, simple process to attach any role and remove any role for a specific admin that we can do. So this is also, I'll be giving one assignment. So this is, I've already shown how to do that. You will be also practicing the same thing. So okay. The next is the preferences. Preferences, again, it is basically the currency, time zone, active local ID. So here you can maintain, though suppose the admin wants all in all his training or all her training in his or her time zone. Okay. So here we can maintain that. Time zone ID, currency, suppose you want in the, say, Australian dollar. Whatever the things you require. Similarly, active local ID means all your, whether it's the English or French, whatever the locals you'll be using. So you will be using English.
Okay. So why currency ID and all it is coming here? Okay, it's for local and time zone. Okay.
Yes. So actually, it is specific to the admin role. Suppose admin wants everything in the US dollar. Even if the catalog is in the Indian currency, it will convert. Means it will show and it's in all the training in the US dollar, specific to the US dollar specific. So that things you will be so able to see that. And also there is an option, always display scheduled offering in this time zone. If you are ticking it, suppose you have in India, you have created a scheduled offering, then it will automatically convert to this time zone, Atlantic Standard Time, American time zone. It will convert that and it will show there in the specific time zone. Okay, to that particular admin. Okay. Then these are again, these things like date pattern, date format, time format, currency format. So all these also we can play around, like what are the change things required, this local format and options. These are optional, but the critical part is the assigned role. This is the critical part, like what roles you are going to assign to an admin. So this is from a configuration point of view. So these are the two critical areas. Whenever you are going starting an implementation from an LMS site, you have to be very much careful. This is the security domain restriction role management. And second one is the creating an admin role. Okay. So these are the critical part whenever you start with an fresh implementation. After your this, because generally we conduct workshop to explain. It takes around, if it is a complex structure, in my last project, I spent one day complete to come to a conclusion for this security part, like domain restriction, role management, because it was a huge implementation for covering around 20 different sectors, covering around more than 20,000 employees. So they had a one day discussion on this domain restriction role management. It is also not, it seems easy, but when it comes to the implementation, real-time implementation, if the structure is too complex, you will be getting challenges there. So this is also starting point also. If it is very much clear from the day one, then the remaining configuration is just a cakewalk. Okay. So it is, it will be sailed through. All these remaining configurations are very easy. So another thing, complicated part is the connector part. So this is I'll be spending more time on this. So other than that, all are just easy thing. If you go to this all other configurations and tools, those are actually the admin jobs, like admin can do all those things. Connectors also actually I have given to the LMS super admin only, because all other admin, they are not technically competent. Okay. So I have given access to the super admin who was a little bit competent. Otherwise, you can give the, if the client is having their own IT people, then you can give a KT to them after the project is over. If support, you are not supporting that project. Otherwise, generally, these things also comes to the consultant. Okay, if you are working in a support project, if the admin is not able to do that, then you have to, generally in support project, you can support all in these kind of scenarios and all.
Okay. So main question, like there is after logging into the instance, we are seeing the admin center, right? Admin center, from there we are entering to this learning administration, correct?
Yes.
So there RBP is there.
So
there is this permission.
Yes.
Okay, so that admin and this admin is different?
हाँ so that admin and this admin is different. So no, we are talking about this admin, right? So here yeah. I have logged in as Das. Okay,
yes,
it is the same user ID I'm using, because actually whenever I'm navigating through this learning admin, we are having a integration. So due to that integration, single sign on and integration, automatically it is taking me to that particular user. Here also you can see the same user ID as Das. So it is the same user ID, so don't confuse about that. It is the same admin, okay? So it's not a different. Okay. Otherwise, you'll not be able to, if he is not having access, so you'll not be able to go to that particular admin. It will be throwing some error.
Okay. So the same, for this admin only, we are working for the role
assignment. For this admin only, we are working. And I'll be showing something here in the manage permission role. We use only a specific part of it, not the entire thing. So if you go to manage permission, I think he is not having access to this. Okay, he is not having this access. I'll be showing in some other instance. Okay. This manage permission role, manage permission, just one tick you have to tick there. So while giving this LMS access, you have to tick, do a one single tick in that RBP permission. And another is for the admin, from just to switch on that you will be having access to the learning admin. Okay, because all the users will not be having access to this learning admin, right? Only the specific users in your organization, they will be having access. Now also this drop down also, suppose out of 10,000 employee, there are only, you are giving LMS to only 3,000 people. Okay, so it is a pretty common scenario. So in that case, you have to control that using that RBP part. So this is just a 5 minute tomorrow's session. I'll be showing that. Okay, so that you will be getting this learning access. Otherwise, all users, all the 7,000 users who are not having access, so they will not be given access to this learning. They'll be having all relevant, applicable, whatever the relevant modules. They have access, only the learning, they can also make them exception. So that is controlled to RBP here. Okay, but LMS admin RBP is different. So what I have described, explained to you, that is the security, completely security structure, domain restriction, everything. So that is part of LMS specific security structure. And we have a little bit of RBP here in the, from the admin center side, from a learning point of view. So that is the overall for today's session.
Okay.
Any questions? Because I'm just covering most important and critical part, and also the critical in the sequence. Okay. I'm not going by this tab and all, because you'll not be able to relate it. Okay. So yesterday I just covered in the basic terminologies for explain item types, your catalog, all these things. Today I just covered the configuration, the critical 2 points. That is your security structure, where we cover the domain restriction and role management to summarize everything. And secondly, we have seen also the how to create an admin, how to attach a role to an admin. That part we have seen. Okay, so we will go through, and it will, I'll be also giving some SMO. You just try some hands-on, because unless you until do and this hands-on, you'll not be able to get the entire
I will come
theme of, sure, it. Also, let me know any questions if you have. Also, can WhatsApp me. If not in email, also you can WhatsApp me anytime. I can go through that and I can help you. So we'll go slowly, and we'll buy 10 sessions or 11 sessions. Mostly 10 to 11 sessions. By 15th, we'll be by 12th around, we'll be able to complete if you are doing every day. Okay. So then we'll be covering 3 sessions for you, especially for all your assignments, projects, or any specific case studies, whatever I am giving to you. And also the whatever assignments, it is actually at present I have given 20. There are actually 100 plus. Okay. So also you take your time if you are not able to complete it.
The PDF you shared with me, that which is having 180 pages.
I say 180 plus pages. That is the first set actually I have given. So that is around 20 assignments. So it is actually, if each assignment, it will take not more than 10-15 minutes. Okay. So you can complete it in 20 within next this Friday or Saturday, whatever available your free time. Okay, you can do that. And later on also can do after this also, if you have any issue and any facing, while you're not able to follow up any specific assignment. You just tell me that this is the assignment number, I'm facing this issue, or it may happen in this test environment some configuration has not been done. Okay, so that can be also an issue. Okay, so just go through that and just let me know if anything.
Yeah, actually, like even I'm also leaving US in the month, this month end. Okay.
Oh, is it? So we are coming back India.
No, actually, the project is set up, like offshore is planning to set up in Philippines.
Okay.
Like I need to be because of the project. Again, Philippines is the new culture to the project. Okay. So why they have chosen I instead of India is like they, those people work complete night, it seems.
Complete
night, which covers the complete US shift.
Okay.
But Indian projects, they not have that liberty. They might be working with some overlapping time only, it seems.
True.
The client prefer to go, Philippines. So I might be there to set up some teams.
Okay. Good. So you're staying with your family there, right? In Chicago? Or?
Yeah, I'm staying with family. But at present, like due to the project situations and client requirement, I need to go there for at least for 6 to 7 months.
Mm-hmm.
And between, like I might be coming to, like I said, I'm not directly going there. I will stay in India for 1 or 2 months.
Okay. If you're coming here sometimes, let me know. We can visit.
Yeah, we'll do.
We can meet, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, sure. But I will be coming to Bangalore or Chennai.
Okay. No problem.
All right. Okay, we'll meet.
Yeah. Chalo.
So that is the reason I was also need to complete everything soon. Like that day you was pinged me, right? Then I very quite, oh my god. See, trainer is interested, I am not interested. I don't want to miss this chance.
No problem, I'll be taking care of it, everything. Even after the completion of this, no point, means there is nothing like that. You can't ask me questions. Anytime you can ask me questions.
Sure,
definitely. Happy to help. And also, the community which I have, the link I have said, right? The PDC community, partner community.
Yes.
You can sign up there and you can also post questions there. I'm very much active there. Okay. I'll be helping directly if any questions there. Also, if I can't answer, I will let you know. And I can get it done by any other experts also. We have in our team. I will let you know.
Sure.
Any help.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
Have a good day. Bye.
Check please that one, the 19202.
I will check and confirm. Mostly it is not, there is not that much change, because LMS there is not that much innovations they have not done in that 2 years. The same is I will check and I will just let you know. Okay, fine.
Yeah. Thanks.
Sure.
Have a good day.
Same to you. Bye.
I don't know how to stop this recording. Recording stop.